Hello, my name is Mark Spildy. I am a senior product manager with our Power Apps team at Microsoft, and today I'll be walking you through the unified interface. I'm going to be sharing with you our navigation, the things that we've done to improve that within the unified interface. I'll be walking you through some of our form structure and what we've done to improve our density and to improve the overall interface with that compared to the web client. And I'll be sharing with you some of the things that we've done to optimize our business process flows. And then we'll give a quick overview of our dashboards as well and the interactive dashboards that we have. So to kick this off, I really wanted to talk about our navigation and what we've done. And some of the things you'll notice that it's fairly similar to what you're going to see coming from the web client. You'll see that we have the ability for your users to quickly navigate using this top level bar. So you can obviously through breadcrumbs, you can navigate back and forth. This isn't any different than what you'll see in the web client. We've also included the standard icons at the top. So you've got advanced find, you've got settings, you've got task flows, you have search. So all of those capabilities that you're used to in the web client are also available here, you know, up at the top with inside of our top nav. And the next thing that I like to talk about is the command bar itself. So the command bar isn't much different other than it's much smaller, so it takes a whole lot more space. We've condensed it, so from a data density perspective, it's much better on the page. It doesn't take up as much room. We've also included the ability, like you do in the web client, to customize these. So, you know, using your custom icons, which can also include color, you can quickly add these different types of commands and navigation inside of the command bar for this particular form. The other thing that we've done is we've actually moved the sitemap from hidden in web client to the left-hand side where it's always readily available for your users. So this makes it much more easy and quicker for your users to get to information, you know, that they need to work with directly on this sitemap. So you can see that we include all of these top level areas of your my work, customers, sales, collateral. All of this is customizable. So you actually can control what you want to show inside of your sitemap at your app level. So it's really easily, as you can see, I can quickly go between leads. I can move between opportunities and accounts. I can move really quickly if I'm in opportunities. I can see my opportunities, but then I can switch really quickly to all opportunities. So we made it much more quicker to interact with information on the page. The other thing we've done is we've included this area switcher at the bottom so you can quickly change your area. This one tells me I'm in the sales area, so now I want to go to my app settings. So you can quickly and easily, just by clicking on the icon down below, here, this option, I can move between these areas very simply and very quickly. And so we made it much more easier for your users to have access to that and move and forth. The other thing that we've done is we've actually created the ability to go to your recents as well. So up here in your home, I can switch to my home page really quickly. It'll go to my sales activity dashboard. But let's say I went, oh, you know what? I really do want to open up an account here and I work with John Smith a lot, so I'm going to move to this lead. You can quickly and easily do that by using your recents. Now I'm going to switch over to the web client and show some of the major differences in how the web client behaves versus the unified interface. First thing that you're going to notice is you've got the command bar at the top. All of this is the same, like you were saying. The command bar here, so you've got your top level nav, then you got your command bar. This is the same, but you'll see that these icons are actually, they're not really, there's no color to them. They're all pretty standard with regards to the interface in the web client, where over here, like I was saying, you can have a color icon. You can change it quickly and easily to be whatever you want it to be. You can add different iconography. One of the things that you'll notice, obviously, like I was talking about, is the sitemap is hidden. It's really hard for users to know where they are, where they need to go within the overall site, you know, within inside of your sitemap. To see that, you actually have to click on the chevron up here underneath sales, which is really not very discoverable. And then you've got to know, okay, which area do I need to work with? I've got to find it, and then I have to click on it. So I'm three or four clicks in just to get to my list page. Where over in the unified interface, I can just find, oh, there's accounts. Yep, I want to go to the accounts page. It's one click. One click versus three, I'm actually at the same spot. So those are some of the major improvements that we've made with regards to the navigation. The nice thing we've also done to improve density, like let's say I'll open up here, I'll open up this JC Sellers here. One of the things that we've done is we made the ability for your users to expand and collapse this as well. So you can see that, you know, you can easily move information on the page that you're looking at. You can increase the size of that by quickly expanding and collapsing. By default, this is expanded. So when your users first come in, they'll see this expanded navigation bar, so they can quickly move in between it. I'm going to move now from our navigation, what we've done in the navigation space, to our forms and what we're doing in the form space to make it much more easier and more compact for your users to get to information. The first thing you'll see compared to the web client, which I will show in a second, is where we've moved the sections that there used to be, or there are sections in the web client, we've actually moved them to tabs. So the first thing you're going to see is that I can quickly and easily move within the, you know, within the side of the unified interface to different areas. This is part of the form or part of the page when you build it inside of our form designer, but you can quickly and easily move between those. In the web client, what we've done, and you'll see the difference here. I'll open up JC Sellers. When you're looking at this, you actually don't know how many sections that you've got. Like, you don't know where the information is. It's hard for your users to find it. You actually have to scroll down to be able to see your details section, to see your contacts. It takes a lot more interaction and clicks and scrolling for your users to get to information that they, you know, they may use quite a lot. So if every day I'm usually in the details page, like you can see, if I've got this fully expanded out in the web client, I have to actually scroll down, especially if, you know, you've got some of these larger sections like the general information. I've got to scroll way down on the page, where in the unified client, I can quickly just go from my summary to my details. It's one click and I'm in the same position where I would have scrolled down, find it, understand where I am on the page with inside of the web client. It's quickly and easily available here within the side of the unified client with just a simple click. The other thing I want to do now is walk you through some of the improvements that we've done with the business process flow and how we've made it much better and easier to interact with. So I'm going to go to our leads. I'm going to create a new lead here. And immediately what you're going to see is the business process flow is much smaller and much more compact. I'm going to do the same here. I'm going to slide this over. And we'll go to leads here. We'll go to a new lead. What you'll immediately see here is that the business process flow takes a ton of space. You actually have moved this way down. And so you can actually see that, you know, in the unified interface, it's much more compact and it's much easier for your users to understand and know where they're at, just because of the coloring as well, like the bullet point. You know that you're on the qualified, where here there is some shading, but it's not as easily to see because here you know that, oh gosh, yeah, I haven't completed these. This iconography, the only really way you know is by using, you know, the light and color, but with the locked signal, you know, this locked icon. So you don't really know where you're at as easily as you do with inside of, you know, the unified interface with our business process flows. So with inside of the business process flow, some of the things that we made it do it so that it to condense this is we've actually created these flyouts. These little flyouts are basically easily to interact with. You can quickly fill them out. They'll pull up information, you know, and then once I'm done, we'll save this. And then what you're going to see is that when I come back up here to my business process flow, the next stage is right there. So I don't have to worry, I don't have to wonder where I am within that flow. And so I can hit the next stage and then it'll, you know, I can create an opportunity for this quickly. I can just pull up my quick view form. I can save and close that. Once that's done, it'll put me back on, you know, it'll show that opportunity and it'll show that it's qualified. So once I've filled all that information in, it's immediately qualified, and then I'm on to the next step. And so then I can continue with that business process flow, and it can, you know, this isn't, none of this information is required, so I can go to the next step. So all of that business logic is built right into our business process flows right here, and it's just immediately readily available for your users, and it's streamlined so that it doesn't take as much space, so they can get to the other information down below on the page. The last thing I want to go over is our interactive dashboards and what we've done in this space. So with these, just like the web client, you know, you can put a ton of information on these dashboards, but we've condensed it. So you can actually see more information directly on these pages. The other thing that you can do is you actually can interact directly with these. So I can change this information, like, oh, I actually want to see actual revenue. And then I can choose the type. So right inside here, just like on the web client, I can quickly choose what type I want to see. It'll switch to that right in there, and it'll show me that information directly inside of that dashboard. So there's some really nice interaction that we've done to increase, you know, the overall usability of our dashboards and how they interact and interplay with Unified Client. The last thing I want to show you is how our Reflow works and how the reactive design of the unified interface helps your users really understand and know where they're on a page much better than in the web client. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start collapsing this down. I'm going to start moving from our extra wide to our narrow. And what you'll see is as I move in, all of that information automatically moves. You don't lose any information. It doesn't get hidden. We just reflow it right there on the page. You can all go all the way down to a small view print. So a small size. And as you can see, we actually include all of that information. And I can even go down to a super small size, right? And at that point in time, when you go to what we consider to be our small, we'll stack these. So it's really easy. You never lose that information. It flows really nicely. And then your users can just scroll down and see the information that they need to. So let's say they're working on something over here and they want to, you know, they want to see that over here, over on the unified interface that's related. They can easily do that. But then you can also expand this back out and you'll see that it's pretty responsive. It quickly reflows. It repaints fairly easily and fast for your users. So with that, I hope you enjoyed the introduction to the unified interface, and we'd love to hear from you about it on our ideas forums, as well as our Power Apps and our Dynamics forums. So I hope to hear from you soon. We'll be looking for all of the feedback, and appreciate your time today. Thank you.